So you may consider putting him turned into a game of Find the Observer Ward.
Yeah, not really much kill potential here on a Timber, generally speaking, but they do isolate him in the perhaps the perfect position. And he's already skilled reactive armor. Perhaps they can kill him off, though. KP already up to 5 stacks here, but it's only a level 1 reactive armor. He's going to get quite low to this MP. We'll have a dagger suit. He might be able to kill him. The South Force down. He still gets the first blood. Oh, man. Not much of a killing.
Chaka,
he's going deep for this courier. It cannot be upgraded for another 40 seconds. Diving the tower, circling around. He may pay for this with his life. But not worth it. Spends his gold. Buys the boots. He runs right into 4 of it. Says, thanks for the gold, buddy, but... Pylite die.
Lynn trying to snipe the creep, but I think Bounty Hunter's gone to this place where teams are so used and good at dealing with the hero that you spend your, like, the first 2 minutes of the game just running around hoping to find something.
Arrow there from S3C, but now decides to run away. What do you think moves first?
It's gonna be newbie with the drow to start pushing some more towers. Drow's level 7, they've got max precision aura. They should be looking to take towers. I say that as Oracle gets dived up top. He was looking for his level 6.
Out in front, lumbering up the river. Pylite almost dead to the neutrals, and they start to converge here on 4F. He's out quite far. The long-range Ignite Lob comes in. Now the arrow to follow. A direct connection. A bit laggy here, but it looks like they found him. They've controlled him. He is not gonna ravage. He too will fall in an MP. Could well be next. Pops to the Oracle. A double grab, and all the while, just farming in the bottom lane, clearing out the wave. It ends up being a triple kill as they go even deeper than anything.
Yeah, that's something.
We're in a bad place, but now Kaka moving in. Looks like they want to go here. KP going to leave things up with the Chakram. Drop down, a quick Observer Ward, popping the dust as well. Pull the chase forward. They do match to connect on Pylite Die here. The arrow with the 3 hero rabbit comes in together with that mid one falling forward, but he's blown most of mana. He's just going to continue to pump damage out, I should say, into the Ogre Magi. Moving forward again, the Ogre brought down, now turning on the Unite to finish off him off. The Oracle's there to save the day, and now the Chakram follow damage before him. Standing strong here in the paint, laying into them, courtesy of that Anchor Smash, pretty new 9 low. With the Gust back, can they finish the job for him? Low? They do end up getting the kill, and it's S3C trying to clean this one up. The Starfall, though, is it going to hit Puppy? It will around the trees. Now brings him down. MP trying to do the trick here. Can he turn around with an arrow as well as a Starfall combo? He's not a chance. It goes for the TP out MP. Give me a crit in the mid lane. Just a Drow Ranger confidently on front. Does up the Dragonlance for a bit of staying here, but this is allowing 4F to work on the Ancient stack, and now they will move forward. Storm Spirit jumping in, but it's right into an arrow from S3C, and Pylite Knight saving, though he's been gusted. He can't get the relocate off, unfortunately. Controlled by the drop, but the trade is there as they get the carry of newbie, and now chase for a bit more. Kaka running into Suruki. Not gonna bounce too much. They do get the multicast, and Puppy goes down to the ding ding. Now newbie diving forward, another arrow, having a fish, not gonna connect. A long range ignite, and KP just going in deep for this one, but he may have gone in too far. The crits are there, the double crit from MP, and then with this Oracle can heal up, he may just drop another dagger from distance. It is enough. They pop him. They end up getting the kill. The neutral gets the last hit, though. Ay, ay, ay. Now an arrow to turn this. MP does get hit by it. The Starfall. The nuke. Faith from distance. Bringing down the PA. A bloodbath in the mid lane. Diving onto top. Mid one with the pursuit. Finds the kill. Will get south, but a... too late. Now Faith trying to TP out. Will he make it through the trees? The ball in. The grab. Mid one. Slams it home. Newbie currently 3 heroes. Not for the mechanism either, which is frequently the pickup for Tidehunters as they relocate here on the bottom lane, ball in onto KP, but it's pretty long left to go. Can they get a quick kill on the Timber? So he's up and he's kept alive. Kaka looking around, the silence on the mirror, slipping game, the ref's too late. Down goes the Torpedo to get in now. And following up, that damage just completely chewing through the Tidehunter. He looks to retreat, the arrow comes off the path, that chain through, and it's Kaka. Nuke him down, they now pursue up.
Just couldn't quite get the initial kill on Timbers cleanly. Great reaction. Oracle was the player of that fight, though. He reacted so fast with the TP.
Puppy. A lot of trouble. Too much nuke damage. Standing against it. Burn down. Moran out. The Agate Scepter. This devastating timing we saw so often.
Oh,
at the last international IO. Plus the Serp kid and handled him out. They go. They brought the big boy down to about a third of his AD before F. No ravage. Being lovely on key, but it's so difficult to go in here. They don't even have tracks. The mid one. Going in and secrets. We can help there, buddy. Enough for a few. Fall. This one secret. Not on the same page. Not showing level of impact. you need to try and take fight around the Roach Pit. Mid went out twice, he's dove in on his own.
You're someone like a PA, you've only got 1k HP, you just melt to that double Star Storm. You can't fight all that easy, not to mention the Eye behind you can get blinked upon and taken up before the fight even begins.
Puppy on the team to keep him alive in these hits.
It's like it's one of those things where if you KB for it's like a game looting KB type thing where you're gonna stay alive but you're not gonna kill anything.
Oh, he's got though from behind the three hero, but he slows it down. The Oracle's there to save him. Now they turn on the Pi, they nuke him down. Face there to secure the kill on Pilotia. Now the Unite kills
the two.
But at what cost? Gods. MP might be in trouble here. Is he gonna have an escape route? KB can hunt him. There's a Timber Chain forward and. Going to work with the Whirling Dead. Another Chakram follow-up. MDO's slow. Oh, so dead. Other than for secret point now.
It could be. Yep. Let's qualify us again, LD. Let's do it.
While I die now, trapped out in the river, and you are an IO who's behind
a strikeout, man.
Be alone.
Yeah.
Let's see. I'm gonna let the tracks come for free as he continues to push Vol Newbie. Confident in their siege potential here, but Secret do have the Ravage. They do have the Desolator picked up now on the PA. The Ravage goes and connects up the entire team. For and in fast, and KP just wants to release the Oracle looking to survive a complete lag fest. But there is the top. KP still surviving. They lost the Oracle. That's the first real for the fight for KP. Surviving. Looking for that quick to start the fight. Heimdall. He knows he's the top. There's right out of there. 3C has eyes on for Pi. Now KB looks more. Right mid one again. Moth gods.
The short breeze though, so that's doing it hurts because it's Bloodstone. But the good news, you're not going to get racks.
Does have some infused raindrops now, but that just to about half HP on the back of that. Very little commitment by newbie.
Still no rabbit.
Actually, can focus on objectives. Done there. The forward Chakram again with gods, and again a storm drops. The dialysis is so well coordinated. Newbie continuing to pick off, forcing up IO buyback. The storm still down for 10 seconds. M3C in again. He eats that Oracle name. Ghoster's there together with Faith. They're going to force out another. Oh, sorry, that was the buyback. IO buyback still now. Spike Newbie on the run, trying to make his way out. S3C. Again, he just. Oh, but MP survived through the stitches. I don't know. Mid one completely YOLO win. No expensive. No relocation. For a very short and underwhelming the job went out of there, but SBC also low on mana. Will not continue pursuit. Kaka, GP out, and he's out of there. The dagger crossing over new game here.
Well, good luck killing me in time fast, and he can even face eating the people, and there's no rights coming out. So it's very difficult for them to fix.
Do they really want the kills? They will successfully pinning down Akka. S3C tried to go in counter, and KP arrives looking to make something more out of it. The Oracle saving and on point, keeping SC alive. He will blink out, but in the end, will end up falling. They had the critical damage they brought to three. They're looking for the daggers there. Chasing forward, can U9 save the day? The Gust only getting two, and they surround KP. I blast the blood, and I even push back up by the Hurricane Pike, but not up the secret. Able to gun, they've gotten four gods, and just like Elite Ghost Scepter. Maybe try and kite this thing now, but they can't really kill a PA.
Yeah. They have no force stabs as well, help push people back to safety.
Group A is DSL group, there are four teams in. We do have MVP Phoenix taking on LGD FY. And that is, of course, for Young, not FY God in the name.
There and IO. And then Tidehunter having Ravage in the late game is just always insane.
Oh, Puppy. Normally you wouldn't care too much about losing a bounty hunter, but come on, attack if they can bring him down. He's dead for a minute. Good enough time to go down mid. Getting their time. Secret. Very patient here. Up against the siege of S3C. Just blinks a little bit over to the side and continues to work on the buildings. They will bring down the melee now. Thinking about sticking around for the rain, but this is time to strike this mid one straight on in. Popping that Aegis quickly. 4F hanging onto the Ravage for Naps, trying to zone them back and go for round number two. He hasn't committed it yet. And they go with the pipe. quick crit there on KP to bring him down low. They might just sacrifice Blitz. The rest of the team get out. Oracle is there, can save the day. He will pop the ultimate to keep KP alive. And now KP backing off again with the track forward. He chains up the cliff. They might just have to let him go. The Timbersaw committing the Shiva's guard. Gets healed up a bit further as the Oracle wears off. Attempts the chain away, but it's a short, underwhelming hop for him. Meanwhile, Ogre getting cleaned up. The BKB committed by MP and S.
They're really key heroes. The Timbersaw just lost some Bloodstone charges, but taking a Rax with the 8, they weren't expecting to get that Rax, so SCCC.
Oh my god, that's the chasing, the closing potential of the secret lineup is enormous.
They're not worried about losing one melee Rax. You're kind of at that stage where one lane of Rax is not at all game-changing, so.
And there's the ball in onto KP again. His face trying to save the day, but the Ravage comes through. Connects on three. U9 getting caught. He tries the Hurricane Spike out, but just gets obliterated as the BKB crit combo cleans up. Kaka and mid one dives deeper, looking for face, going for the TP out there. It's a pull. 1 second. Can he get it? No, but he gets KP instead. A sweeter treat, perhaps, as he drops as well. Three of them.
Don't have much firepower right now, at least not until Timber and Drow respawn.
Only the Drow buyback available. Meanwhile, Secret have 4 to work with, plus mid one. Balling with 18 Bloodstone charges. We'll see a quick jump in and an even faster leap out by S3C as the melee Rax advantages immediately. Heading to the south side. Secret can converge on this. Still no Ravage for 75 though, so they want to be careful about how they engage. But MP has the BKB and he isolates KP. He starts to work on the Oracle there. Instead, it's S3C. They turn back for it. Now that the Oracle's committed his ultimate, S3C has to get the hell out, but he won't. Explodes in a cloud of blood and PA crits. The chase forward, another takedown. MP out of control. 3, could be 4 with the ball in. Another set of Bloodstone charges. Put mid one at 22.
As well as MP on this Storm PA, being able to just dive for kills, chase after. There's such great synergy between these two heroes with the track of Puffy and Nubia just getting run over. This is suddenly looking like almost like a guaranteed win for Team Secret after a very... I mean, it's meant to be a bad early game. You're up against a Drow strat. That held on so incredibly well this game.
They'll back off for that easy range Rax in the mid lane. 2 full lanes now caved in.
Seen it. That's what happened at top and started pretty much the fall of Newbie was SCCC pushing out that top lane, gets relocated or brought down, and then just snowballs out of control from there. So the fact they have...
Hero off on his own is Puppy and the Bounty Hunter, the least important hero at this stage when you have this kind of lead.
He has some info, but looks like they are ready to push top. They're not rushing it. They know that age is the last 5 minutes.
Quick jump in and on to Kaka they will go. They force out the Oracle just to save an Ogre Magi. That leaves KP virtually defenseless if they can focus him down. He frantically scrambles back, so MP diving in with the BKB, and it's just a quick crit with the Bloodthorn combo. Newbie lose one. They almost lost a second there. Now with the Oracle on cooldown, anyone who overextends will be jumped. With impunity, Secret branding down the tower, another leap forward, and a quick and decisive takedown on U9, forcing the Mirana back. The server can't even keep up with the raw damage being pumped out by Secret as Newbie throw in the towel. What was a very impressive beginning has become a rather depressing end. They end up dropping this game 31-27, but more importantly, down 30,000 gold, down Mega Creeps in a matter of seconds, and with no chance of comeback.
Yeah, that's like a great game of Dota where you have this team who's got this Drow strat, they take a lane of Rax, they're kind of just looking like everything's going according to plan, but then suddenly Bounty Hunter kicks in, they win that. All it took was that one Ogre pickoff that turned into 4 kills. If that doesn't happen there, it's still a slightly newbie-favored game, not to say it's by any means like